Hello everyone. Today the topic of my presentation is conditions of farmer and recent agricultural research. So let's begin with it. First of all, the Indian farmer is a living idol of India. They are the most hardworking farmers around the world and always busy working hard for their crops during day and night. India has about 1 million people in it. And this makes India's food need the second highest on the planet. Now, India is called the land of farmers as most of the people of the country are directly or indirectly involved in the agricultural sector. Nearly 3/4 of the workers in India are engaged in feeding the nation. It would not be wrong to say that Indian farmers are the backbone of the economy and the farmers are indeed the beloved of the mother India. A farmer's living conditions are literally very sad. For him to get his meal daily is a big thing. Sometimes he doesn't have enough money to sustain himself when there is no crop. An Indian farmer is not at given much importance even though India salutes its soldiers and farmers. Farming is the process of growing a wide variety of crops. India has a diverse culture with approximately 22 major languages and 720 homeland languages spoken in India. Now, farmer suicides in India. The National Crime Record Bureau of India reported in its 2012 annual report that 1,35,445 people committed suicide in India, of which 13,755 were farmers, 11.2%. Now, as you can see the graph, most of the farmers have burdens of loans from bank and private money lenders, which they are not able to return and hence have to take extreme steps like suicide. In the 1990s, India woke up to spate a farmer suicide. As per the latest study conducted by Chennai-based Institute and leading English daily, The Hindu, which states that about 2.5 lakh farmers across India committed suicide due to agriculture-related problems in year 1995 to 2016. Now, organic farming for the sustainable environment includes. First of all, we should know about the organic farming. Organic farming is a method of crop and livestock production that involves much more than choosing not to use pesticide, fertilizer, genetically modified organisms, and antibiotics and growth hormones. Improvement and maintenance of the natural landscape and agro ecosystem I will discuss some points which is related to organic farming. Avoidance of over-exploitation and pollution of natural resources, minimization of the consumption of non-renewable energy resources, etc. Now, this is the graph which states the development of organic farming in India from 2002 to 2007 or 8. Now, situation of Indian farmers. Role of moneylenders still plays an important role in agricultural story. Lack of loan facilities from commercial banks make farmers take a loan from moneylenders at high rates. This drives them into a debt trap if they are not able to repay the loan. Now, Mahatma Gandhi National Rural Employment Guarantee Act, which was passed in September 2005 under the UPA government of Prime Minister Dr. Manmohan Singh, but it was launched on 2 February 2006. It is an Indian labor law and social security measure that aims to enhance livelihood and security in rural area, providing at least 100 days of wage employment in a financial year to every household whose adult members volunteer to do unskilled manual work. Now, the income of the farmer will be either marginal or there will be any profit or loss. Good rainfall, good yield, and good prices never come together. So, the income of the farmer will be either marginal or there will be any profit and loss. Only large farmers can use machineries and achieve good productivity with low production costs. every farmer wants his children to get out of agriculture because they are aware of the difficulty in agriculture. And also, there are many schemes implemented by the government, by agriculture, central and state government agencies. But I think 10% has not reached the farmers. Now, recent agricultural reforms, reduction in public investment in agriculture, including in research and extension, they is in enhancing productivity, accelerating agricultural growth, and reducing poverty in India. Reduced spread and rising prices of the public distribution system for food. If the price will be low, then the people will buy more, and who cannot afford can also get the food. Liberalization and removal of restrictions on internal trade in agricultural commodities across states within states. This helps increase revenues, decrease competitions, better risk management, beneficial for currency exchange, etc. Now the conclusion. Now the current status. Agriculture remains. Agriculture. Now this is a graph showing that various people are investing their rupees in agriculture sector, industry sector, and services sector. As the farmers borrow their money from money lenders, traders, relatives, and friends, landlords, and others, and institutional, government, cooperatives, commercial, and rural banks. Now, agriculture contributing to GDP section. Now, the conclusion is that even though India is known for agriculture, this sector is very underdeveloped. The farmer that feeds the nation is hungry himself. Thank you. I hope I clear all the points, and thank you to listening to my presentation.